shape yourself, but instead of the center panel being wood, you can actually add some texture.
David, are you ringing?
The furniture that we're going to express, and there's a cushion that's
yeah, you have the what controls?
Your remote. Okay, let me get the look for you.
Knit.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It feels good, and I think it adds a lot of warmth.
Just your mind.
Generally, when you have a flat slab kitchen, yeah, it's nice to add that extra and support things up.
Beautiful.
So, of course, when we're talking about what to do, it's kind of just talking about what not to do.
Yes.
So, when I say mix and match, I'm going to show you a picture. So, this is a suite of furniture. It's sometime around the 50s and 60s. Retail is
not in here. Okay,
if I can sell you a sofa, I can sell you a sofa, an armchair, and a one seat.
You're not sleeping on it?
If you haven't done it already, don't do it. If you've done it already, take one of those pieces and give it to your son, your daughter, your yeah. extra neighbor, and put it in a different room. Mm-hmm. Because it's nice to bring in, typically in the balance, it's cozier.
Mix it
so
up.
Mix and match.
Yes.
So another picture I'm going to show you. This is a picture. I'm not a huge fan of tons of pop lights. I understand pop lights still have their place, but you see yeah. a lot of pop lights in that type of basin.
Lots of pop lights.
Yeah.
You have this one.
That is one effective
to me. Effective lighting. You want it to be costed.
Did you have it this morning?
You want to light up a huge space. What are you suggesting?
So, by the way, that's a before the
light. Oh.
Instead, like it's nice to have a
under your bed.
I get this beautiful long linear channel.